with the agenda sees this, he will surely be convinced that I am a messenger of peace and I condemn all terrorist attacks. Any human being, whether Muslim or non-Muslim, kills any other human being, whether Muslim or non-Muslim, an innocent human being, I condemn that act anywhere in the world, whether in India or any questions or any clarification that anyone requires, you're most welcome to ask. I request that this is not a panel discussion, so I request the journalist to ask one question at a time, please mention your name, and the news agency, the channel or the paper you're coming from, and be patient. I'm here. Whether it takes half an hour, 1 hour, 1.5 hour, I'm here. So please don't get impatient. If anyone is impatient, has an appointment, then I cannot force him to stay. But I'm here to answer your queries. Don't get impatient, even if it's the time, if it's time for Salah there in India, all right. Maybe the Muslims can go for Salah, but all the other journalists can very well continue asking the question.
Tell me, when can I start? Yeah.
Then we have the first question, please.
All right.
Maybe have the first question.
Yeah, I have my, I have the mic.
Okay, yes, Megha.
So, if Dr. Naik is ready, it's on, right? Dr. Naik, my name is Megha Prasad and I'm from Times Now. My question.
Yes, what can you for, sister? How are you?
I'm good. My question to you, Dr. Naik, is that, you know, there are videos that are available on the internet in which you have said, and it's there freely available for everybody to watch, you have said that killing people by way of suicide bombing can be justified in certain circumstances and under the guidance of some Islamic scholars. I would like to understand, sir, what exactly did you mean by advocating killing people by suicide bombing? And number two, who are these scholars you are referring to, who you think have the right in this world to go ahead and give the permission for suicide bombing? And before I end, Dr. Naik, I would also like to know, why did you cancel your visit to India? Because clearly your staff had gone on record to say that you're coming back on 11th. Were you apprehending the state?
Mr. was clearly mentioned one question at a time. You're asking the second question.
One question at a
time. Both these questions are covered in the pen drive we'll be giving. I told you, I've compiled it, but people are impatient. And if you hear the recording, that recording is given without any pressure, very calmly, without anyone forcing anxiety. Here, regarding your first question,
yes,
that you have seen my videos that I have advocated killing people in way of suicide bombing. Again, this is a misinformation. And this answer is given on the pen drive. There was a question asked to me that is suicide bombing permitted in Islam? And the reply is, if suicide bombing is done as a terrorist attack, where innocent people are killed, this is 100% condemned. It is not permitted in Islam. It is prohibited. It is haram. And it is the second major sin in Islam. And I've put it that most of the scholars, Islamic scholars, like for example, Sheikh bin Baz, for example, Sheikh Uthaymi, all of them condemn that suicide bombing where innocent people are killed. It's totally prohibited. But when the question is it permitted in some cases? There are certain scholars that give you the name. For example, Sheikh Safar al-Hawali. If it is used as a tactic of war, and it was used in the past. I know when I spoke to some journalists, they said, come on, Zakir, where has it been used? Your knowledge of history may be a bit weak. If you know in World War II, Japan used it as a tactic of war. There were kamikaze pilots. What you have to realize that these scholars say that if it is used as a tactic of war in which the Amir, the head, the leader of the army of the country gives permission that if this is beneficial for the army of that country to win over the enemy as a tactic of war, if someone does it, in these cases, it may be permitted. Otherwise, in all cases, where innocent people are killed, like a person takes a bomb, goes in a marketplace, goes in a bus, goes in a train, goes, all these are 100%, they are condemned. And all scholars throughout the world, they condemn that suicide bombing or suicide attack where innocent people are killed. It is 100% wrong. It is the second major sin in Islam after associating partners with God. This was the answer to the first question.
Dr. Naik.
And this is given in the complete context. But imagine Dr. if Naik. Someone shows only one part of my answer,
Dr. Zakir.
Which even answer I Dr. gave, Dr. if you show one part of the answer, it can be misunderstood.
Dr. Naik, being an Islamic preacher, shouldn't you be sensitive towards the kind of words that are being used? While you come out with the statements, you are a public figure and you have so much of huge fan following. Shouldn't you be sensitive towards the kind of words that are being used, because they are being misinterpreted as you are coming out and saying? But then certainly there are a lot of many other charges with respect to the same statements that are against you.
So say your name and news agency.
I'm Urvashi Khona from NewsX.
Now you tell me one thing. If an army general of a country thinks that he can save the country, it may be India, it may be any other country, that he can save the country if some of the soldiers go and do a suicide attack in which the country is safe, there are many people in the world who would like to give their life to save the country. So I have to give the complete answer. And that's very important. You cannot just I'll give you an example. For example, everyone knows that alcohol is prohibited in Islam. If someone asked me, is it permitted in some cases? I said, yes. If alcohol is going to save a life of a human being, in that case, alcohol is permitted. This is given in the Quran. So what you have to understand, I give a general answer in the starting, and I told that all suicide innocent people are killed. It is condemned, and I don't think so any logical person will take it out of context. It is the media, for the ulterior benefit they may take. Anyone who knows English, when they hear my answer, if this was the case, I'm giving this answer from so many years. Why hasn't anyone come in the question answer session and told me that why are you condoning suicide attacks? And in my lectures, there are many non-Muslims, no one, because they understand clearly. Later on, if someone picks it up and he alters my answer, shows part of my answers and misguides the people, so the person who's altering and manipulating my answer, he should be held responsible and should be behind bars.
I don't think
I myself saw. They show part of my answer that Dr. Zakir Naik said suicide bombing is allowed. This is totally wrong. It's out of place. So I say that why are they manipulating my answers? Okay, my answers in the full context, anyone who knows English very well cannot misunderstand it.
डॉक्टर साकिर मेगाकेश त्रिवेदी जी न्यूज से आपसे हिंदी में सवाल पूछ रहा हूं और आपका हिंदी में जवाब चाहूंगा. आप पिछले 25 सालों से जो है दावा कर रहे हैं, आप इस्लाम के प्रीचर हैं, आप कई सारे दावे करते हैं लोगों को इस्लाम के नजदीक लाने के लिए. मेरा सवाल आपसे ये है कि क्या आप जानते हैं कि इंडिया में मुसलमानों की हालत के बारे में कि कितनी प्रतिशत आबादी अनपढ़ है, बच्चों का ड्रॉप आउट का परसेंटेज क्या है, और इसके अलावा यहाँ पर भारतीय उद्योगों में बड़े ओहदे पे कितने मुसलमान है, क्या ये फिगर्स आपको पता है?
Hey, this is not on topic. This is not a relevant question. Not a relevant question.
No, let him decide that. No?
Yes. 1 second. Relevant question क्यों नहीं? उनको आपको जवाब नहीं पता है? आप ये बोल लीजिए. एक मिनट. डॉक्टर जाकिर अगर आपको फिगर्स नहीं पता है तो आप बोल लीजिए आपको फिगर्स नहीं पता है.
Not a relevant question.
Yes, sir. जाकिर अगर आपको फिगर्स नहीं पता है तो आप बोल लीजिए आपको फिगर्स नहीं पता है. आप मुसलमानों की हालत नहीं जानते भारत में क्या है. बताइए चुप क्यों है डॉक्टर जाकिर आप?
Sister at the back. Yes, sister.
आप इस्लाम के बारे में जानते हैं, मुसलमानों
की हालत नहीं जानते
आप? Go ahead if he's not answering that question.
Dr. Zakir Naik,
आपको जवाब देना होगा. Dr. Naik,
my name.
Dr. Zakir Naik, आप मुंबई के हैं.
Wait. Let the sister question first.
Let him answer first, please.
Let the sister question. Yes, sister.
इसका मतलब ये समझा जाए कि आपको इसका जवाब नहीं पता है? हम यही इसको
टेलीकास्ट करेंगे. This question is not relevant. This question is not relevant.
Obviously, it is relevant.
Yes, sir. अरे चेयरमैन की बात मानिए, ये आपका रेस नहीं है. ये आपका प्लेटफॉर्म नहीं है. चेयरमैन अगर बोल रहा है एलिमेंट नहीं है, आपको चेयरमैन के ऊपर तमीज नहीं है तो आपको इस शो में नहीं होना चाहिए.
वो चेयरमैन ने बोल चुका है कि ये प्रेस कॉन्फ्रेंस के लिए आपने बुलाया, ऑफिशियली इनवाइट किया है.
आप जो भी पूछेंगे
इसका मतलब सर ये है कि आपको ये फिगर्स नहीं बताएं.
मुझे फिगर एग्जैक्टली आपको पता है क्या? फिगर्स किसको पता है कितने परसेंटेज है? मुझे फिगर्स मुझे भी नहीं पता है. और क्या जरूरी है इंसान को बताना चाहिए एग्जैक्ट फिगर कितने? 2 crore, 4 crore, 5 crore, or 6 crore, or 7 crore.
Your name?
My name is Smita Nair. I'm from CNN News 18. You claim to have answered the first question that was put to you about suicide bombings. I don't know why you are presuming that there is some agenda here. we are going by your documented statements, both in print. Can I please phrase my question? We have seen, I for one have seen the entire clip related to the question on suicide bombing, and at no point while giving your answer do you outrightly condemn and explain to the young man who asked you the question that this kind of suicide bombing that is carried out by terrorists is haram, as you said. At no point do you explicitly say that. So the question here is, these are young, impressionable, quote, fans of yours, as you claim, and you have been deliberately ambiguous while answering questions such as these in the kind of fraught atmosphere that we live in currently. So to that extent, you are definitely responsible. That is my assessment after having seen your videos. And two, why do you sound so
smart?
Sister,
one question at a time.
Why do you sound so smart, Dr. Naik, when you say that all these terrorists who carried out attacks are fans of mine? You're almost saying it as if it is a badge of honor.
Sister, let him respond.
Regarding the question that you saw, my answer is you said bombing, and never did I ever condemn that people going in the bomb and killing innocent people is wrong. I challenge you, sister. It is your remark. I challenge you to show me any answer which is unedited. We have the recording. You show me any unedited answer. You might have seen an edited answer, sister. I challenge you to show me any answer on suicide bombing in which I have not condemned that taking a bomb or going in a marketplace or going in a train or going in a bus. The words may differ here and there. Every answer that I give on any answer that I give on suicide bombing, I have made it very explicit that what is done nowadays, where people get up in the morning and they take a bomb and they go to marketplace, it's totally prohibited in Islam. Just because you say you have seen a doctor clip. What I want to give me proof. Tell me proof. This is a lecture. Here is a recording. Unedited. We'll see it. Just because they've seen a doctored clip, you're so confident. Did you do a survey whether it's doctored or not, sister? That is the problem. When a person is coming in front and is very open, is very honest, and is saying, I've never said that, you have to take it as face value. Imagine if I really am there to encourage the terrorist, and if they see this recording of mine where I 100% condemn all attacks where innocent people are killed. I've said that several times. Why are you relying on the doctored clip? Or an answer which is out of context, or an answer which is partly presented here in front of you. I am telling you direct. If you don't agree with me, that shows that you doubt me. I challenge you. I challenge you, sister. Show me any unedited. We'll give that clip in, if you give it to me, I will tell you whether it's doctored or not. It is totally unethical for you to not take my answer on the face value.
Dr. Naik, again I say,
killing any innocent human being, it is the second major sin in Islam. It is prohibited. Quran says in Surah Maida, chapter number 5, verse number 32, that if anyone kills any other human being, whether it be Muslim or non-Muslim, unless it be for murder or for spreading corruption in the land, it is as though he has killed the whole of humanity. And if anyone saves any other human being, it is as though he has saved the whole nation. This verse is the verse of the Quran of Surah Maida, chapter 5, verse number 32. I am a student of comparative religion. I have read scriptures of various world religions. There is no scripture in the world besides the Quran which makes this claim that if you kill one innocent human being, you have killed the whole of humanity. And if you save one human being, you have saved the whole nation. And I agree that maybe you have seen a doctor clip. You go to our YouTube channel. I have spoken thousands of times. Maybe there may be 10 sentences where you can take out double meaning. But there are thousands of sentences in my talks which condemn unequivocally, unambiguously, that killing innocent people is prohibited. I'm repeating it how many times? So how can you say that someone can be misunderstood? What should the media do is, and what should the agencies do, that who are these people who are using Dr. Naik's popularity for their ulterior motives? They should catch them. Instead of doing that, you are blaming me. I take it as a badge of honor. It's not a badge of honor, sister. And I give this answer that I know because of my popularity, there are about 200 million people watching on Peace TV. On my Facebook alone, there are 4 million fans. I have inspired millions of people to come close to Islam, to come close to peace. But all the millions of people who are my fan may not follow 100% what I say. Some may follow 100%, some may follow 80%, some may follow 50%. Now, when a person gets inspired and comes close to Islam, there are some speakers who are misguiding the innocent Muslims. And they tell them that when you kill the other non-Muslim or innocent human being, you will go to paradise. These people are misguiding the innocent Muslims, and they are against the Quran. What I'm telling, that these people who misguide, they should be caught and arrested. Now when you're showing throughout the world that Dr. Zakir Naik is saying that you should kill innocent people, now those people who are my fans, those who don't know me very well, and they know I'm popular, they will really start thinking I am saying kill innocent people. So what the media is doing, the media, because of my popularity, they are again creating more innocent Muslims to take the wrong action. What right does the media have to misquote me?
Dr. Naik.
And
Dr.
Naik. What I say, that today, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, is one of the most influential human beings in the world, even according to Michael H. Hart. And all these terrorists, they may be influenced by Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. But nowhere has ever Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, told the people to kill innocent people. So you can't blame Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, for the act they have done which is wrong. For the act what they do right, you can blame Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. For the wrong acts, you cannot blame them. Similarly, if people are inspired by my lectures, and if most of them, almost all are coming to the state path, but if some of them are hijacked by certain speakers who are misguiding, how am I to blame? It is like a doctor, who's a very famous doctor, and he has saved thousands of human lives, but he was unable to save 5 patients. And the media says, this doctor, he kills the patient. It is unjustified.
Dr. Naik.
Yeah, first India Today and then ABP. Fine? Yes.
Dr. Naik, I'm Sahil Joshi. I'm from India Today. And I also represent the Hindi channel Aaj Tak. अभी आपने एक बहुत बड़ा जवाब दिया एक सवाल का जिसमें आप कहने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं कि आप किसी भी तरीके से इन सारी चीजों को सपोर्ट नहीं करते टेररिज्म को आप सपोर्ट नहीं करते आप कह रहे हैं कि मीडिया ने आपको मिसरिप्रेजेंट किया और उसके वजह से ये सारा मामला खड़ा हुआ है लेकिन दूसरी तरफ ये भी देखा गया है कि गवर्नमेंट ने आपका टीवी इंडिया में बैन किया हुआ है पीस टीवी ठीक है गवर्नमेंट को लगता है कि पीस टीवी पर आपके जो स्पीचेस है जिसके वजह से भावनाएं भड़क सकती है आप लोगों को गलत इंस्पिरेशन दे रहे हैं और उसके वजह से तकलीफें हो सकती है इसके वजह से पीस टीवी इंडिया में बैन किया हुआ है व्हाई डू यू थिंक दैट इफ यू थिंक दैट यू आर नॉट योर लेक्चर्स आर नॉट सपोर्टिंग टेररिज्म योर लेक्चर्स आर नॉट सपोर्टिंग वायलेंस देन व्हाई इज इट दैट द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट हैज बैंड योर पीस टीवी इन इंडिया सेकेंडली विल यू कम बैक टू इंडिया एंड फेस द राइट नाउ द इन्वेस्टिगेशन इज ऑन बाय मुंबई पुलिस ऑर्डर्ड बाय द महाराष्ट्र चीफ
वन क्वेश्चन एट टाइम
विल यू कम बैक एंड फेस दिस पर्टिकुलर इंक्वायरी यू थिंक दैट you should come back and face this inquiry when this thing is going on at this point of time.
Two questions. The first 3 or 4 questions that were asked have already been answered in my 30 major allegations and by the media. Even these 2 questions have been answered. You see the pen drive, but I'll answer it again. No problem. For your satisfaction, I'll answer again. Your first question was that why has Indian government Information Broadcasting Ministry has banned PST? First of all, the point to be noted, we applied to the IMB, Information and Broadcasting Ministry of India, for downlinking rights in the year 2008. Let me give you the background for better understanding. Many people say Peace TV is illegal. Point number one, Peace TV is a legal satellite spiritual entertainment channel, which is uplinked from Dubai as well as from London. Both have got separate license. It's a legal channel. And both are independent, both have different board of directors. Now, today in the world, most of the countries do not require a downlinking permission. But there are some countries, or rather many countries, I think it's less than 50%, who require a downlinking permission. Amongst them, there is UK, there is Pakistan, there is India. India in the year 2006 said that any channel which has to be shown on the cable TV requires a downlinking permission. Now, in 2008, we applied, in 2008, Peace TV applied for the downlinking permission and the INB did not give without stating any reason. It said it's confidential, it is Home Ministry. Again, Peace TV applied, they didn't give the permission. So you are asking me this question, I am asking to the INB that why hasn't INB, Ministry in India, have given the downlinking permission for Peace TV? Why? When UK, which is the strictest country in the world for having downlinking permission, and it has an Ofcom regulatory body, which is very strict, they have given us the permission. What I want to know, and I request you to ask the INB why they have not given. Just by saying security reason, or just by saying confidential, that doesn't work.
Zakir Naik, where is the question of it being banned?
The ban can only be there when, if a country has a downlinking permission, and if the country has given downlinking permission, then the question of ban arises. On those countries where downlinking permission is not required, then that country can put a ban. There is no country in the world that I know of where Peace TV is banned. If you want to say, though technically it's not correct, that India has banned because it gives a list. In the last couple of years, it gave a list of the channels which don't have downlinking permission, and they are very popular in India. Most of them were Pakistani channels, and others mainly were Muslim channels. That's from Saudi Arabia. That shows the Makkah Salah. The second channel is from Medina, which shows the Medina Salah, and as well as Peace TV.
Doctor, if someone says today,
there are more than 27,000 satellite channels in the world, and in India, less than 1,000 have the downlinking permission. So would you say that more than 26,000 channels in the world are illegal? And it's totally wrong to say that more than 26,000 channels in the world are illegal. That means more than 96 channels in the world are illegal. Just because downlinking permission is not given, it doesn't become illegal channel. Yes, it may be illegal for the cable operator to show it. Regarding ban, the only country, technically, if you want to say India has done, okay, I've got no problem. But technically, only one country a few days back, that is Bangladesh, has put a ban on Peace TV. And I would like to ask the Bangladesh government also, and the Information and Broadcasting Ministry of Bangladesh, that why have they banned? Show me one program in Peace TV which is detrimental or not conducive to the society of Bangladesh or India. I would like to ask the media, why have they banned? And all these clips that are shown, these clips are out of context. See, in UK, they have a regulatory body. You point out one full program, not clip of 2 seconds or just a clip of 10 seconds or 1 minute, the full clip in context. I challenge anyone, any of the media, to show a full program, a full episode of Peace TV, which is not conducive for the country of India or not conducive for the country of Bangladesh. So that's the reason you're asking me the question, why it is banned, even I don't know. And I would like the media to ask the INB to show me at least few programs.
Dr. Naik,
what we're showing is clips from the YouTube, from the social media. These clips that shown from the, which is shown on the social media, which is doctored, some of them are doctored, many of them are out of context. They cannot be held responsible. All the clips that he showed, it is shown somewhere else. What I would like the media to put a pressure on the INB and to find out why have they not given us permission. The only reason I can think is because it's a Muslim channel. It's a Muslim channel. And it is an Islamic channel. Now, coming to your second question.
Yes.
Coming to the second question, which was asked even by the reporter of the first question, that are you willing to have an inquiry? And I've told that earlier also. If there is any inquiry, I'm not there for the media trial. It's not obligatory on me to answer the media trial, yet I've come there. If there is any investigation by any official government authority, so far there is no official government authority that has approached me in the last more than 8-9 days. None. Neither my office, neither me. It is the media. More than 100 channels, from throughout the world. More than 100 newspapers from different parts of the world have approached them. Not a single Indian official government authority has approached them. If any official government investigating authority has any query, if they want to ask me any question, I'm most welcome. I will answer them. I believe so far, as far as I am concerned, I have had no problem with the Indian government. I had no problem with the police so far. Never ever in my full life have I ever been called for investigation. Yes. Being a public figure, I've met most of the police commissioners of Bombay. I've met the additional commissioner. I've met the joint commissioner. I've met the department in India, in other parts of the world. They come. I've even gone and giving lecture in Hyderabad. That is the IPS center where they change people. Twice I've gone there. But not a single time have I ever been called for any inquiry whatsoever by any of the police, neither in Bombay, neither any part, neither any city of the full country. Never. GC, there's an investigation going on, he was called for inquiry. All this is media trap. Yes, I've met most of the police commissioner in the last 10 years. I've met the additional commissioners. I've met the joint commissioners. I've met the anti-terrorism department head. I'm a public figure. I go and I talk to them. But never ever have been I called by them for any investigation whatsoever. In the newspaper, Zakir has been in the radar of ATS, of the Bombay police, or so and so. He has been investigated several times. This is all nonsense. 100% nonsense. And who's to blame? Is the media apologizing for that? Any inquiry, any official government authority wants, I am willing to cooperate 100%. I will answer any query. And if I can catch any terrorist anywhere in the world, whether India or outside India, who's killing innocent human beings, it would be my pleasure to cooperate because I condemn the killing of all innocent human beings. I would like the media to hear this. And I've said this in my lecture more than 1,000 times, that killing innocent people is prohibited. And I have never encouraged any time in my life, even a single time, for anyone to kill any innocent human being. And I hope that is very clear.
डॉक्टर नायक, आई एम जितेंद्र दीक्षित फ्रॉम एबीपी न्यूज. मेरा आपसे सवाल यह है कि अभी अभी आपने कहा कि पीस टीवी को इंडिया से डाउनलिंकिंग का लाइसेंस नहीं है, लेकिन इसका आपने तोड़ यह निकाला कि हार्मोनी मीडिया प्राइवेट लिमिटेड जो कंटेंट बनाती है पीस टीवी के लिए, उनकी ओर से सीडीज और डीवीडीज इलीगली दी जाती है केबल ऑपरेटर्स को, और वो आपका चैनल दिखाते हैं इस तरह से. ये कई जगहों पर हो रहा था, और खुद आपके हार्मनी मीडिया में काम करने वाले एक एम्प्लॉय ने हमें यह बात बताई है. उसने ये बात भी बताई कि हार्मनी मीडिया प्राइवेट लिमिटेड के जो एम्प्लॉयज हैं उनका शोषण किया जाता है. 5 साल का कॉन्ट्रैक्ट कराया जाता है और उसके बाद उनकी आधी सैलरी जो है 3 साल तक जो है काट ली जाती है.
ब्रदर
नहीं, बिल्कुल रेलेवेंट है.
आपका सवाल ब्रदर आस्ट अ क्वेश्चन दैट हार्मनी मीडिया मेक्स डीवीडी, हार्मनी मीडिया नेवर मेक्स डीवीडी. Yes,
I'm aware.
Let me reply. Islamic Research Foundation, several years back, in 96, 98, in 2000, yes, we used to make DVDs and we used to give to cable operators, not Harmony Media. Harmony Media did not exist at that time. Harmony Media doesn't make any DVD except backup of its own program. Never ever has Harmony Media ever given any single DVD to any cable operator. Yes, I am aware that Islamic Research Foundation many years back used to give DVDs to the cable operator to show. Harmony Media is an independent company. It has no link with Islamic Research Foundation. It is a company which produces software. And you know, today in Bombay produces software for thousands of channels. And many of the channels which Bombay produces program, they don't have the downlinking permission, as I told you. You may not be aware, there are more than 27,000 satellite channels in the world today, and less than 1,000 have got downlinking permission. That means more than 26,000 channels don't have downlinking permission. Out of the 27,000 channels, there are hundreds of channels whose programs are made in Bombay and in different parts of India. Just because the channel is making a program for someone who doesn't have a downlinking permission, you'll be shocked to know that there are certain channels in India which have uplinking permission, don't have downlinking permission. They have uplinking permission. There are few channels, maybe 7 or 10, which have got uplinking permission, but I don't have downlinking permission. So when they have uplinking permission, but naturally they produce programs. What I'm trying to say,
Dr. Zakir Naik
has got no link with the DVD given to the cable operators. It does produce program, it produces entertainment spiritual program. It is a legal entity. It's a company. It's a private limited company. There are many companies which are making for Walt Disney World. There are many companies making for various channels in different parts of the world. And they export it. So what's the problem? What is illegal in it? And why should the media ask me this? They're asking employed. They have a 5 years contract. We are giving employment to Muslims who don't know. We train them. We train them in graphics. We train them in editing. And when we train them, we sign a contract which is done by many countries. That when we train them, we do not charge them any money. What we tell them, that here, if you want to be trained, we train you. For me, it may take 1 year. It may take 1.5 years. When we train you, we will not charge any money to you, but we will give you a particular compensation. And if you complete 5 years, we will give you a bonus. That if you leave in between, we will not give you bonus. So suppose we say, okay, you have started now. Instead of you paying us, 10,000 rupees, we will pay you every month 5,000 or 10,000, whatever it is. But if you complete 5 years, what? You will get a bonus. You will get a bonus if you complete 5 years. If you don't complete 5 years, you will not get a bonus. It's for many companies. It's a legal document. It's allowed by law. Now, some person who is disgruntled comes to you, or some person who wants to become famous or wants to make money comes and criticizes the channel. Why don't you ask the other people also?
Dr. Naik, this is
Rashmi. What we realize, this is the media.
Dr. Naik, this is Rashmi Rajput. I work with the Indian Express. My question to you is, the father of two of the alleged IS recruit in a recent interview told that you have met them in person.
तो क्या बड़ी बातें अब तक कही गई हैं वो आपको जरा बता दें डॉक्टर जाकिर नायक की तरफ